Hi guys, Mark here. I hope you are well. Today's tutorial is going to show you how to make a simple rope bowl. These are usually made out of a round mat with the sides tightened up to create a bowl shape. So let's get into it. For this project, I'm going to be using rope 5/16 of an inch in diameter, so about 8 millimeters. The length of my rope for a 4-pass bowl is going to be 28 feet, so about 8.5 meters. You can use many different types of rope. I'm going to be using sisal. Look into manila, cotton, hemp, jute to find something that you like. During various points in my tutorial, I'm going to be using a bit of tape in order to secure my rope, just to prevent it from unraveling or fraying. I highly recommend stitching your bowl. To do this, you're going to need a needle and a bit of thread about the same color as your rope. This way, your stitching is not going to really stand out. A fid or a Swedish fid is going to be used to do our splicing. Scissors are our final supply. We now tie a thump mat. Tape up the two ends of your rope. Fold your rope in half. Wet the right end. Make a loop. Pass over your loop like this. And again, over the second loop, going over two, under one. Then, here, over two, under the left end. Then, weave, over, under, over, under, over, under. So, over, under, over, under, over, under. Like this. Place your working end alongside the other end, so over under here, tying one pass of our thump mat. Now adjust it a bit so that you get even looking bites here on the sides and a nice round mat. Something like this. Take one of your ends, so in this case the working end, and follow the other end through the entire mat. When you run out of rope in your working hand, use your standing hand to do the same thing. We're going to do this until we get 4 passes in our mat. So the standing hand now follows the other end through the mat, tripling up, then quadrupling our mat. So like this, a 4-pass thump mat. We now shape up and tighten up our mat. First, check that you have the two ends together like this, getting a complete 4-pass mat. Secondly, your bottom end should be facing towards the right, the top one towards the left. So this side is going to be the bottom side. Now shape up your mat into a bowl. Like this. Tighten it up, starting at one of your ends, going through the mat, and into the other end. Like this. So this is one pass of tightening. As you can see, I'm trying to keep these outside bites facing directly up and not bending inside or out. So directly up. You may want to do a second pass of tightening to remove any gaps in your bowl. When we're happy with the look of our ball, we're going to secure the two ends by splicing them through our passes. To do this, our ends need to be as long as our four passes, like this, plus a bit extra. This one here is a bit long, so I'm going to shorten it up a bit. Unravel the two ends a little bit. Tape up the inner strands. We now take our strands, unravel them a bit, to about the middle point here, where we're going to splice them in. So these three strands are going to travel like this, one next to the other. I'm going to start with this one, travel, under a strand in the first pass, under a strand in the second pass, under a strand in the third pass. Then the next strand travels parallel like this. And our final strand on this side again travels parallel. This completes one of our sides. On this side, we again unravel a bit so that one of our strands starts here in front of our first strand from the other side. So here, then the next one is going to go next to this one, and the next one next to this second one. So the first one is traveling solo here through the first pass, through the second pass, through the third pass. The next strand travels alongside this strand from the other side. The last of our strands travels next to this one here. Now, pull on all of your strands to really lock them in. Trim them as close to your passes as possible. Optionally, you can pull this spliced part under a section to hide it out of sight, like this. Move this slack around the mat to even it out. So something like this. So the splice is only visible on the inside, and even then, it's not really visible. To finish up our bowl, I highly recommend that you stitch the outside bites to make them stiffer, and they're going to look much better. To do this, take about a foot of thread your needle . Tie an overhand knot on the other side. Start by attaching your thread around the strand in the second pass. Like this. Then, move up through our first pass, then down through the three passes at the bottom. Pull firmly to really lock your four passes together. Move here to the side. Go through the four passes until you reach the top. Again, pull firmly. Then, move down, and again attach your thread around a strand in the second pass. Like this. Bury your thread a bit deeper into your passes. Trim the two ends. And you have stitched one of your bias. You have five more to do. So guys, a simple, decorative and practical rope bowl. Thank you very much for joining me today. See you next time.